Carry on my wayward son, there'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest, don't you cry no more.
Yeah, we are in at the end of January. It's rather cool here during the night. So we have our thermometer here, and this thermometer is quite interesting because you see this little stick here, and there's another little stick there. Now, if you look at the numbers on the thermometer, it goes here from 0 to 10, 20, 30, 40, up 10, 20, 30. But here you have 0 lower, it goes up 10, 20, 30, 40, goes down 10, 20, 30. Now, this part here is the minus part. So it shows, this one shows what the lowest temperature was. So that is somewhere 16 degrees, the lowest temperature during the night. But this one shows...
I think it's 15.
No, yeah, 15 or...
15,
yeah. For me it looks like 16, but anyhow. Mm. It's the down part that counts, because that's the one that is being pushed. Mm. Now this one here, it shows that the highest temperature was 36. That was probably during during earlier days, you know, because we did not adjust it yet. We need a little magnet to bring these little things down. But see, so it shows the difference in temperature between highest temperature and lowest temperature. I think it says here minima and maxima. See, but it, you have to read it a bit like that. Minima and there maxima.
Minima. Maxima.
Mm-hmm. See, now I'm showing you that because it's quite interesting to know. Because such plants do very well when the temperature is 16 degrees, 20 degrees, while other plants have a hard time because they rather love the sun and warmth. Now we will go at the back and we will show you the difference. Now, like I said a while ago, we show you the difference. Now we have here cabbage crops. Cabbage crops, they grow best when it is cooler. They do better. Now, when we look at our broccoli, it's the first time that we get a big broccoli like this, and it's still growing because this time it is really abnormally cool, 16 degrees in the morning. Normally last year it was not 16,
but there was 19, 20.
Yeah, but you see it really affects the broccoli. Even there's another big one there. There's another big one there. And our cauliflowers, which normally are only very, very small, they're getting bigger too.
Here also, look.
They're getting bigger too because it's cooler weather. See?
Yep.
But then when you come here, be careful you don't fall over anything here. When you come here, we have our cucumber.
Pickling cucumbers.
Pickling cucumbers. You see, you look at the the fruits. They're very small still, and it's already it's already 1 week that they're just like that. They don't really grow too much.
Yeah.
Because it's too cool.
Yeah, there's one here that grew.
Right here somewhere. I think where was that? There's one here. Became a bit bigger, and they're becoming bigger there too.
Yeah.
So they were the first ones to grow it at the bottom.
Yeah.
But they have a harder time now because it's cool. So we're hoping for a little bit wetter, that is warmer, and then Dan is going to change these yellows now, so that the sun can still come in more, because it's just on top of the cucumber. Then you also can see it on the jalapeno. They suffer from the cold.
Here also, you take a look here, the effect of the cold weather. As you can see, the Chinese pet chai, the curl more inside. Normally, at this time of the year, they are open, it's so leafy. But now you can really see it's
they
really...
They try to close, yes.
It's really closing.
Yeah, it's closing.
Yeah, which is what you get when you're growing them higher up, you know?
Because we could reach here at 16 degrees, no? Mm.
Yeah, 15 or 16, I think it's low. The lowest is 15.
But then our fruit crops have a hard time.
Look at the jalapenos. Because of the cold weather.
And it has some sakit also.
Because of the cold weather, and it's susceptible to sicknesses. But still, they have a lot of fruits.
They give a lot of fruits.
Look, look at this one here. They're good.
We'll just continue
here. Look at that, though.
They still give fruits. The hardy plants.
Yeah.
Then you also have it here. Yes. There you're starting the tank to close. There's cabbage.
Cabbage.
You're trying to close a little bit.
Yes. They're really very beautiful.
The start of closing.
Our imported, how do you call this?
Melon.
It's still small. It remains still a little bit like this.
Yeah, but I think it's already
it's a little bit bigger just a little
it's what do you call this, pollinated,
because
it's not pollinated it will just turn yellow
it should
fall off.
It should have fallen off.
There's another one here.
Yeah, there are several. This one here too. Where is that? Here, there. This one too here, and another one here, and then there are there also.
So hopefully all of those will become,
but the problem is fruits. That they have some aphids,
and
that's not so good. See, we have a little aphids
here.
But those are also older leaves already.
Yeah, first leaves.
But I will spray with neem extract, because that will discourage the aphids. The same with our
pickling cucumbers.
Yeah, pickling cucumber.
The papaya. You know, this is the kind of papaya that we can buy in SM. You know, single serving, no? You can see here, how do you call it? They are very nice. We got the seeds from the the one we bought from SM.
Yeah.
And then, there are still some fruits.
Yeah. And afterward, we're going to uproot it, or else it's going to put a hole in the roof.
Okay.
What you are seeing now is a common cutworm. A common cutworm is the offspring of night moths. And these common cutworms, they eat the leaves. You can see the side of the leaf there, it's already eaten.
Yeah.
See the margins of the leaf, they're eaten already. Now, if you want to know more about insect pests, like this one, and what to do with them, everything is discussed into details in volume 2 of our book.
Yeah, but the thing is also, although this is protected, you can see that there are still insects that could get inside. What is really important is that no matter how it is protected, still the insects have their way of going inside.
You have to check.
Therefore, you have really to take care. You have to take a look every now and then. So that's
check
what happened
constantly.
Today, yes.
So I will be killing that fellow.
But then that can you see the cauliflower? It's already vaulting. You can see that. Okay, that's really the size. Here.
Maximum size.
So that is already the maximum.
Maximum size for the kind of weather that we have.
Because some of the flower tops, they're becoming longer than the rest.
Yes. Yeah. That is the sign that reaches the maximum size.
Yeah, you can see it quite well here also.
Yeah.
You can see the... Anyway, I will be getting in to make a picture of this cutworm and kill it. So that it will not... destroy all our plants
or feed it to the tilapia.
Yeah, we can do that. But it's not because there's one cutworm that therefore it's a big pest. It's just one singular cutworm.
That is very normal.
That's the thing that you should do. You should always look at your plants, check them.
Mm-hmm.
So you won't have an infestation.
Yeah, then that's a problem.
That's part of being organic. You really have to take care of it.
Yeah.
One last look.
Yeah, it goes where it is. Okay, I will take care of this fellow.
So I just finished replacing the corrugated iron roof with fiberglass. So our pickling cucumbers and lady fingers or okra will get more sunlight. I still need to change one more strip, but I can only change one strip in a day or the sun will kill me. It's really intense up there. So I would rather just take my time than to have a heat stroke and go through the fiberglass roofing and plant my head in the seed or the plant beds.
Anyway, we have still time, I know. Yeah. Still have time, so next time we'll look.
Yeah.
Next time again, or Wednesday maybe.
Yeah.
And then we still haven't formed also.
Yeah,
eventually we will also change those.
Yeah, I need to change, I think, three strips of corrugated iron roofing into fiberglass ones.
Yeah. Well, our problem before was how to clean and go on top of the fiberglass because we might just step through it. But now we found we just use corrugated iron sheets, we make a triple and put them on top and we can walk on it.
So it can support the Belgian weight.
Yeah. Okay.
There's a big spider with it's carrying its eggs. It's still alive.
Oh yes, it sure is. It's normally that's inside the house. Eh? You see those look inside the house.
Mm-hmm. There's a big dog sitting here. The spider might bite Wolfie.
No,
and he might go into cardiac arrest.
I will kill it.
What? Okay, no. You just leave it alone.
Leave it there, no?
I don't want to get bitten by a spider.
Okay.